Hi, I'm Joni Hilton, your YouTube mom. I want to debunk some myths today about what prevents colds and common household remedies. Some are good, some aren't, and I'm going to run through a bunch of them so you'll know what to try for various things, bug bites, all kinds of things. Let's start with onions. There's a rumor going around that if you slice up some onions and you put them in your bathroom, in your bedroom, in your kitchen, it will prevent the flu. Not true. Ever since the 1500s, people have been saying this, and it's not true. Now, onions are great, they're healthy. Chop them up, put them in a chicken soup, and then you get some electrolytes at least. But just breathing the smell of onions isn't going to help you avoid anything. Okay, baking soda is known to alleviate indigestion. Why? Because it takes care of the acidic nature of your tummy by making it alkaline. So just take a spoonful of baking soda, mix it in some water. It's going to taste terrible, but it'll settle your tummy. Now, this is an interesting, I really like fennel. It has a slightly licorice taste, so a lot of people who don't like licorice don't like it. But this is actual fennel you can buy and cook. But what you can also find are fennel seeds. And fennel seeds, if you chew them up, or if you crush them and make them into a little drink, that's also a tummy settler. Just don't use more than a teaspoon because it's got a slightly laxative effect. And of all of this, check with your doctor. I'm not a physician. I'm just talking about home remedies. But always check with the doctor before you do any of this stuff. Let's move on to honey. Now, some people say that honey heals cuts and scrapes and scratches, and it's a good thing to put on your wounds. Is it true? Yep, it is true. Although the better honey is a medicinal honey that you can get at the health food store. But both work, it's just the medicinal one works better. All right, there's also a theory that if you want to reduce fever, put some ice under your arms. Guess what? It actually does do that. It will reduce fever a little bit. Same with the back of your neck, because you have capillaries under there that can take the cold very quickly to the rest of your body. But when you do it, be sure to wrap it in a towel, because you shouldn't put ice directly on your skin. Now, why do I have toothpaste here? Believe it or not, peppermint oil, which you find in toothpaste, can soothe a bug bite or a bee sting. So that's good to remember. Just make sure you're not allergic to peppermint oil, because some people are. Now, this one, duct tape. What on earth could duct tape be for? If you put a piece of duct tape over a wart, it honestly can remove the wart. Not because you're going to yank it off, but because if you leave it on for a little while, a few days, a week, and only do this for 2 months anyway, but the duct tape, it isn't that it deprives it of oxygen. That's what I used to think. What's really happening is it's boosting your immune system to come to the surface more and kill the virus that causes the wart in the first place. So it does work. Now here I have a penny. An old, old wives' tale is that you should put a penny on a bee sting. Nope, sorry, doesn't work. You know what's better? Dip a cotton ball in milk, or try ice, try a hot spoon, believe it or not, or try putting some kind of a salve on there that's like an aloe, and that will kind of help you a little bit with a bug bite. This is an interesting one, tea. Tea is supposedly very good for healing cold sores if you just hold the tea bag against the cold sore. How about that? Now, this is supposed to be a remedy. A little bit of flour, white flour, is supposed to help burns. Nope. You gotta get some aloe gel. That's what really helps burns. Or cold ice water. If you've burnt your fingers particularly, just keep them submerged. If you pull it out and it hurts, damage is happening. Stick them back in. And the last one. Dark chocolate. We hear lots of interesting rumors about dark chocolate, right? And it's supposed to help with a sore throat. And my thought is, who cares? It actually is one that works. A little bit of dark chocolate can soothe a sore throat. But 1 or 2 ounces, that's all you really need, unfortunately. Don't get a 10-pound block of chocolate. Or if you do, send it to me. That's it. I'm Joni Hilton, your YouTube mom. Be sure to visit my website, Joni, J-O-N-I, Hilton.com. Subscribe. Tell your friends to subscribe. And if you have something you would like a video made about, write it in the comment box. See you next time.